Hello students, today we will discuss some concepts that are required to understand normed spaces. The very first concept is a metric space. What is a metric space? Let X be a some non-empty set. A metric on X is a real valued function on X cross X. A metric is some function which will work on X cross X, and what will be the outcome? That outcome will be a positive real number. Metric is a function on the Cartesian product of a set. X is a non-empty set. A metric on X is a real valued function. A real valued function whose output is real. Output is real. When we are substituting some pairs in this function, the output is a real number. And this function is satisfying the following properties. What are the properties? That the distance. We are representing this metric by the symbol D. And the D of XY is always greater than or equal to 0. The mapping is always positive. For every pair, the answer generated by D is always positive. And whenever the terms X and Y, the points, just for example, 1, 1 point we have considered, 2, 2 point. Whenever X and Y are the same point, X coordinate and X, we are taken the same values, then the distance, the DXY is always equal to 0. And D of XY is equal to D of YX. This means it is a symmetric for every X and Y. And the very important property is a triangular inequality, that D of XY is less than or equal to D of XZ plus D of ZY for every XYZ belonging to this. This D symbol, basically, this D is here denoting the distance. It is a distance between X and Y, and it is a non-negative real number. Okay? So this inequality is a symmetry because we are denoting D with the distance. So distance from X to Y is same as the distance from Y to X. Distance, whether we are going from X to Y or whether we are going from Y to X, distance is same. Distance between the two points is always greater than or equal to 0. Distance is never negative. And between the two same points, distance is equal to 0. And this is a triangular inequality, means distance from X to Z, Y. We are directly going from Y to X, and we are using some other point, say Z. We are going to Y using the path X to Z and Z to Y. So obviously, XY distance will be lesser than this distance X to Z and Z to Y. So this inequality is called a triangular inequality. So this type of a function D from X cross X to R with these three important properties is called a metric. And a set X together with this metric is called a metric space, written as a pair X, D. Set X together with this kind of a function is called a metric space. So we note here that D X cross X to R positive. This kind of a function is called a metric function. And D will map pairs to some real number. That real number is a positive, means this R is always greater than or equal to 0. Here we have some examples of metric space. Let X be any non-empty set, and we define a metric, a function, by D of XY is 0 when X is equal to Y or 1 when X is not equal to Y. This kind of a metric is called a discrete metric. If X is equal to R, then we define a metric on set of real numbers by X minus Y mod. Distance between two points in the real is defined by X minus Y. This type of a metric is called a usual metric. What is a convergent sequence in a metric or a Cauchy sequence in a metric? Suppose XD is a metric space. Any sequence XN in D is said to be convergent if there is a point X belongs to X, such that for given epsilon greater than 0, there exists a positive integer n satisfying the condition that the distance of x and x is less than epsilon for every n is greater than or equal to n. This definition means that there should be some point x such that the sequence lies in the neighborhood of x. In the epsilon, this radius is epsilon, and we have chosen a very small neighborhood of X, and very small neighborhood of X is containing infinite many terms of this sequence. infinite many terms of this sequence are very close to x, distance between the points of sequence and x is very small. When n is greater than n, n is greater than n means n, this n is tending to infinity, n is very large. So what is a convergent sequence? When sequence is converging to some point, it is approaching to some point, it is not scattered, it is approaching to some point. And we also write in the simple that the limit of n tend to infinity of xn is x, or we may also write that xn tends to x as n tends to infinity. What is a convergent sequence? When sequence is approaching to a particular point, and which is written as the sequence is tending to x, the distance of terms of sequence from x is very less when n is tending to infinity. What is this n? Is a number of terms of the sequence. N is greater than n means the larger terms. Sequences ki kis tarike nal form karte hain, first term of the sequence, second term of the sequence, third term of the sequence, and the larger terms when n is very large, those terms are very close to x. And what is a Cauchy sequence? A Cauchy sequence is if for given epsilon there is a positive integer n such that distance of terms of a sequence is very small when the terms are very large. Xn and xm are those terms of the sequence. Suppose I am writing the sequence terms of a sequence on a real line, I am just putting the terms on a sequence. So a sadi first term hai sequence di, a say suppose second term hai, and when the terms are very large, so n xm larger term, xn larger term hai, ina terms da jina de suffixes bahut large ne, they are some large natural number, so these terms have a very small distance between them. Nth term and mth term of a sequence are very close to each other when n and m are very large numbers. So these are two main definitions which we will repeat again and again. We will use these definitions again and again. For defining normed linear spaces, we will use a vector space or a linear space as a base. What is a vector space or a linear space? These are this synonymous of each other. Vector space is a same as a linear space. Linear space means a vector space. So a vector space or a linear space over a field, field of either real numbers or a complex number, is a set X with the operation called a vector addition. Vector addition will take two terms. Addition karan de li do terms the requirement undi hai. So this vector addition operation will work on X cross X, and addition give us only one answer. So this will map to only single X. It is defined as X comma Y is X plus Y, and another operation is an operation called the scalar multiplication. And scalar multiplication is a function which will map f and x, elements of set and real or complex numbers which are called field, to generate x. This means ki when we are multiplying scalar with x, we are again getting element of the set x. So what we have done, a vector space over a field f is a set X which have two operations. One is a vector addition operation and second is a scalar multiplication operation. In the vector addition, this is our observation that the sum X plus Y should again belong to X, and in the scalar multiplication, this is again our observation that the scalar multiplication of X is again in X. And these are further satisfying the following axiom. These two operations, so this is an axiom for the addition that X plus Y plus Z should be X plus Y plus Z. Means when we are adding numbers, association should be there. We may associate the first two numbers or the second two numbers. Addition should be commutative. Whether you plus X plus Y or Y plus X, answer should be same. There should exist a number zero which is called the identity of addition, such that X plus 0 should be 0 is equal to 0 plus X, and there should exist some element Y in X such that X plus Y should be 0 should be equal to Y plus X. Here this element Y is known as the inverse of X. This number Y is called inverse of X. We also write this Y to be X inverse. this is a axiom for the vector addition, and this is a axiom for the scalar multiplication, that multiplying x plus y by a scalar is same as alpha x plus alpha y. Alpha plus beta x is alpha x plus beta x. Alpha and beta are two scalars. These scalars are belonging to the field, which may be either real or may be complex. And alpha into beta x is alpha beta x. And there also exists an identity. There exists one belongs to x, such that 1 into x is equal to x into 1. Here the elements of x are called vectors and the elements of field are called scalar. And if any set x together with these two operations satisfy the following axiom, then that set x together with these two operations, one is for the addition and second is for the scalar multiplication, this is called a vector space. We have considered x, we have defined two operations on x. One is the addition operation, second is a scalar multiplication operation, and from these two operations we have satisfied these axiom. If these axioms are satisfied, then this set x together with these two binary operations is called a vector space or a linear space.